HPZ is a game of moderated tag.
Whenever a zombie tags a human, they get converted into a zombie.
The idea behind this game is we're trying something a little new, where we have the humans divided into two teams.
It's a very non-biased, like, hey, just join us, feel free, we're doing a mission or whatever, just join us kind of thing. And it's really nice. It's like, you kind of eliminated every single other prejudice or bias you would have on someone just simply on the premise of you're playing a game, which I think is a really positive thing.
Because except for Monday.
Oh, yeah.
Monday is
okay.
Not.
Oh, okay, yeah.
It's team-based and...
Yeah, you could have one hand from... Or you could have one person solely...
I think that they would divide up. Well, Thursday night, they probably would have to divide up into seven.
No, it's...
No. It's, the missions will stay the same. It's just we're going to move them around.
Well, the
making
whole
new missions
Monday was literally just for...
Individualized.
Yeah.
Which, I'm saying we could... We scrapped one mission. I know we scrapped one mission or changed it around a lot. I think we scrapped Tuesday's original mission, and we can make that Monday's mission now.
HPZ is humans versus zombies. We just call HPZ because it sounds awesome and it's an abbreviation. It's basically just a huge tag game with apocalyptic events.
Humans are trying to run away and escape from zombies, and then zombies are trying to tag them. And humans can fend off those zombies with Nerf blasters or clean balled-up socks.
And whenever a zombie tags a human, they get converted into a zombie. And that's pretty much the premise of the game. It's a giant game of tag, essentially.
Well, the idea behind this game is we're trying something a little new, where we have the humans divided into two teams based on a corporation. People are fighting, and this corporation acts as... acts to settle the disputes in what they determine is a civil manner, where you collect people, usually lower class citizens, you collect them into your army, which are your representatives throughout sort of a Hunger Games-esque style arena. And the humans will act as these two teams, and they will be fighting each other throughout the week against the zombie horde to complete their objectives, which act as the games. And then whoever wins will win the dispute over a water treatment plant, I believe it is, which is vital in a post-apocalyptic world. I mean, you need clean water.
I don't have class Tuesday till 4 p.m., so 6 I can
p.m.
stay up late, 6 p.m.?
Yeah,
6 p.m. So Uni can, like anyone else that can stay up, Uni can just like look through the numbers, crunch the numbers, and make the teams themselves.
Yeah,
we what we should do prior is make out cards for that team so we can hand them out to people. You know what I mean? So like Tuesday, when they show up, they can give us our name. They can give us their name. We can just be like, oh, you're this team.
So Mondays was, what's going on with Mondays?
Still not done with extraction.
Oh, go ahead, sorry.
Yeah, there's an awesomer part to this. So after this back and forth has gone on for a while, when one team is finally completely killed off.
Or near dead,
or
I would say. Because if it's one person who sprints off.
The way extraction works is that since they're in two teams, we want to put them against each other
mm-hmm.
for like an actual like almost like game where they want to kill each other. They can't blast each other, but they want to kill the other team off before the extraction can even open up. So the way it's gonna work is are each gonna have some type of thing to signify like their safe zone that they're pulling around. Like we said, shopping cart could be a backpack, just something.
Mm-hmm. I have the notes right here if you want me to read them off.
If you want, but right, yeah.
It might be more straightforward.
Alright, so both teams get a moderator with a backpack, which is a portable safe zone. Both zones are active at the start of it. The mod leads the team to different points on campus, telling them only one point at a time. And at these points, humans complete mundane tasks that make it so more people can be extracted. And the backpack is a puzzle book. Both teams have access to the book off the start. When a team completes their first puzzle, the other team's safe zone falls. When your safe zone is down, you must complete the next puzzle to bring it back up, and this will shut the other team's safe zone down. Okay, you cannot access the book unless your safe zone is down. When a puzzle is completed, the humans get 1 minute to run, or some arbitrary time, to run to another safe zone, like at a door, before the safe zone becomes inactive. And this will prevent, like, the massive horde of zombies that we know will be following both teams from just killing them all right away.
So those two mods are going to need, like, walkie-talkies or something?
Yeah,
to
yeah that was
like,
what all the talk
okay.
before was about.
Our hope is that the humans will, that there will be conflict between the two human groups and not just the zombies. The idea is to get humans out there instead of staying inside and not doing missions, because missions are optional. So what the idea behind the two teams was to get them to compete with each other, to get them out doing the missions to make sure that not only are they surviving against the zombies, but they're doing better than the other human team. And when you do better than the other human team, your chances of survival go up.
The fun part on the administrative side is setting up the game. Like, we're like, all right, we have a good idea what's going to happen, but we don't know. Because somebody could break the game by just doing something. There's a chance that somebody could break it and that we didn't see. But we try and plan for that.
Let's say I'm a CVIP, right? I have a backpack. I have, like, 30 flags or something in it. I get shot by a human VIP. I hand that VIP one, and then I go respawn. Mm-hmm. And then that human VIP at the end... is like, I was for team A, they got 10 points, and then we had them all at the end. So, like, they do get something physical. That's what I was at, but we could just do the points.
I mean, that's fine, too.
It might just be better for some, like, to keep track. There's no, like, cheating. I don't look like the Miles wouldn't, but there's six of us here. We'll say we're all human VIPs. I guess we'll all go hide somewhere on campus, and they'll
in pairs.
In pairs.
All right, say a hunter comes across a ZVIP of a different color. What's he
you doing? Can stun it to kill it, or you can keep on going.
Okay.
But you don't get anything
make
for
a respawn?
It. Yeah, you don't get anything for it.
Oh.
So you can effectively screw over your team or the other team.
Cool.
Basically, I don't want to pause the game for much longer than it takes to take your team that survived to the point. I don't want to go much longer than that.
It was going to be at moderator discretion. Like, it was going to come over the line, oh, they solved their puzzle, their shield is up now. The moderator's not going to say anything. He's just going to look around and say, okay, there's a huge horde right there. And then he's going to say, 1 minute until the shield goes down.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Not if that person who has a puzzle sprints away from his groups and says, screw his partners,
okay.
That sucks. Like,
so
he's going to hold it out. He's going to hold it out. The guy's going to take it. And
then you should
follow
the
guy with the puzzle.
I want everyone to have a good time, and I make sure everyone else is doing their job on time rather than last minute or the day of. Because the game being planned the day of or the day before is not a good thing. Or just the day of, like 5 minutes, that some people do that. They set up a mission. They're like, all right, we're doing this for the night. Well, we, our administration, definitely set forth a planning and getting it set up before the game.
We have to work on missions, which takes place over months. It's a group effort. You know, people come up with their ideas, we tweak them, we have to work through game balance. And once we get that done, then we have to advertise the game. That takes about like a week, 2 weeks to let people know that, hey, this is happening, because we have about like 800 people play. So we have to make sure everybody knows. And then once that happens, the week before, we have to have registration sessions all week. We usually have about four to get people signed up on the website, ready to go. And then finally, when week three hits in the fall or week seven in the spring, then the game actually happens.
Well, like, before it starts, there's like, you go to the registration session and you watch the video, you can ask the mods questions. Like, there's a ton of rules. Like, they always mention, like, you know, don't be that guy that tries to find the loophole in the rule just to be that guy. Because we've got like 5 pages of rules or 6 pages of rules, and it's ridiculous. But you can ask questions like, you know, if I have a hoodie, does it have to be over the hood and stuff? And that's when you get a lot of people like talking to each other. Like, that's when you see a lot of people like getting into groups for clans and whatnot.
To prepare for a registration session, it's about... Well, for the registration session, we have to register people, we have to take pictures, and then we have to sign waivers, and then go over rules. I wrote the rule presentation PowerPoint. Those are the rules that get broken the most, ones that I don't want people violating, like people throwing blasters. That's one that one's happened before, and we emphasize that, and it hasn't happened since. So. Having all that set up, like this website, the paper, the printing card for the Wallace Library is where we get them printed. All that usually takes a week or two beforehand, making sure that's flawless. It used to be a lot rougher. Like, it used to take 4 hours to just get pictures taken because the site was slow, the printer wouldn't work. So we've made it much more streamlined in the way we present and the way we organize. We used to do the rules videos first and then do pictures, and that was just pointless. And then we have the videos now that make it much, much more entertaining. But having all the supplies there, having some people to know how to run and do it rather than last minute is a couple of things.
HVZ tags doesn't exist.
Okay.
I'm just making sure, because everything just disappeared. Well, yeah, I was going to get there, but...
Yeah? No, I'm saying that's who your proposition is for.
So this is our Wednesday registration session, one of our four. We bring all the players in and give them a briefing of the rules. Then we bring them up front and bring them through the website registration process, take their picture, and print off their player identification cards. We give them their cards and send them on their way with the bandanas, rules, and everything they need to know.
Hello? All right, that works. So we have a new website, so that means you have to, unfortunately, re-log in, new passwords and everything. You can do that at hvz.rit.edu. Just do that on your own computer, or we have those two computers set up. Then once you have that done, you're gonna go over there to that box, grab a waiver, sign it, put out all your name and information, and then come to one of these two computers, and they'll check off your boxes that you need for like waiver, sign, bandana. If you don't have a bandana, Trumbull will be collecting money for that, and he has a few back there.
What they're doing now is they're registering on the site using their RIT DCE account number, and then the RIT password, because now our website is integrated into RIT's
server. Oh, we have to use the RIT password?
Yep. And it'll just automatically get all of your profile information from RIT's server and put it in here. So hopefully that'll streamline things for people.
Cool.
Do you have $5 for each day right now?
Sure, and you're good. Max? Here.
I have it set up already.
Here.
See, camera.
All right. Anybody else?
Can you fix it? I'll
help. Four things. That's me.
Four things.
All right. So, yeah, I'll check modded blasters. Cosmetically or internally. Fine.
So, if that was happening to somebody.
Fine.
So to check modified blasters, I check to make sure I take the blaster, load it, and then shoot myself with it and see if it hurts too bad and leaves visible, massively visible marks, like bruise on impact marks. And then if that's true, I just don't let them use the blasters, or they have to change it back.
We're going to Wallace Library to the second floor to print out the ID cards on very nice high quality paper in very nice color, so our players can be happy.
Print 3 through 18.
All done. Back to the movie.
We used to do the rules videos first and then do pictures, and that was just pointless. And then we have the videos now that make it much, much more entertaining.
One of the moderators now was doing an HPC movie just for like fun, and he knew most of us, so he's just like, hey, we don't have like an instructional video or anything to show any of the new players. Want to be in it? So I was like, well, I don't have anything going on this Saturday, sure. So that was a lot of fun. Like, we had to, you know, I had to get shot a couple times and whatnot. One of the things we did was how to like react after getting shot, like so people aren't just like raging the entire time, like, oh, I got tagged, or so. One of the things was we had a zombie come up and tag me, and I was supposed to stun him, and like as he was running up, I just missed, and he did it perfectly, and it was like, you missed, and it was like, yeah, I kind of missed. So everybody was just kind of like, he was right there, and. Like, I just completely missed. He was a couple feet off, and he was like a foot in front of me.
I missed him.
There's nobody gonna be out, especially now, to disregard the raider coming down right now.
Humans might not be out, but.
And that guy with the raider's coming as well.
Alright, we gotta work.
Probably shouldn't say this, but I typically skip my classes the week of HVZ because that's how intense the game gets for me. This quarter, that's not the case. I have to go to a couple of my classes. My Tolstoy professor would be rather upset if I skipped. But I typically skip some of my classes just to be there for the Horde because I take it a responsibility on my part to make sure that everything's going well and that people aren't breaking the rules. And it's just, it's too much fun. It's hard to resist being outside in the spring or the fall and just running around having fun with friends.
Really, I don't change that much. I'm not going to skip classes and stay in the dorms because there's a game going on and I can't leave the building. It just means that when I'm going to class, I'll usually stay on campus instead of heading back to my place between classes. This quarter, that's not so much an issue because all my classes are in large blocks. But for the most part, it just means day to day. It's just a little more panic, a little more adrenaline between classes. And other than that, it's mostly the same. If anything, I get more work done during HVZ week because I'm not going back to my room and messing around on the computer. I'm staying on the academic side and usually use my netbook, get some work done between classes.
It's kind of rough depending on how your courses are scheduled. Primarily what it is, it's like a lot of my courses, because I'm a science major, will be in College of Science, sometimes in Gleason for any of the physics, math, or engineering courses that are sometimes held there, or biochemistry, which don't understand why. And any liberal arts courses are in the liberal arts building, so I can just hop in there. So what I have to do is I'll go to my first class, and then I'll just stay in the building all day. So it's not the most healthy thing, but I do get to move around. Like, if I have free time between classes, I'll help people move between buildings. So it breaks up the monotony of it.
Okay. I just like that there's like 36 written marks on that.
Yeah. Do you want to do the fake non-player?
Like, over the goal or?
Yeah.
Okay.
3 up to the left, about 11 o'clock.
You see them?
They're at the tiger statue.
Ah, shit, I know who they are, too.
Yeah, I know.
They're waiting.
I know.
Do you want to just book it?
Do you want to go for it?
Alright, I guess we're booking it.
We're going for it.
Just move quick.
Yeah.
Anywhere is a free play area. Like, if you're outside or out of 15 feet from a door, you are free game. Like, a zombie can tag you out there. So getting to class itself is a challenge because you have to go outside usually. Like, RIT has the tunnels, but the tunnels don't go everywhere. And every night they release a mission that the humans have to do. Like, go collect parts for, you know, a computer to send out a signal or something. And if the humans complete that mission, then they get some sort of progress toward making extraction easier, they get antivirus codes, they get something like that. But the zombies get some information based upon how they've done in the previous missions. Like if they did really, really well the previous mission, they might get more information about the next mission. The zombies are just trying to stop the humans from preventing them from completing any of the missions and stop the humans from getting extracted.
I like seeing the chaos that happens of the missions, but it's controlled chaos. Like, what versus, hey, go here, we don't know what's there. I guess messing with people a little bit is a little bit of fun because we can throw those little plot twists in there that we know is gonna happen, but they don't. Or, like, one of my favorite missions is an escort mission, or because you take one of us, one of our moderators, one of our admins, and then you go with them to wherever they need to go, or they follow you and they protect you. Like, those are always fun because it involves us back in the play style versus us just trying to moderate and make sure people don't break rules. Now, the missions are the best part of the game. Like, if you don't go on a mission, you're missing at least 80% of the game. The other 20% is running to class from zombies.
I'm not sure if you guys know the exact contents of the mission tonight, but essentially, I'm gonna split, we need 10 people, well, 11 people, to guard spots, which is like literally all of us.
Guard or?
Like, be it, spots. What's gonna happen is.
Stand outdoor or indoor?
5 will be outdoor, 6 will be indoor.
Okay.
We're gonna take these, I'm gonna cut them up so they're gonna be strips. The 5 people inside, we're each going to get one, like, so, like, one person's going to be the catch strip person. They're going to take the 2 catch strips, and they're going to go to the spot I tell them to go to. Same with the website, the photo, the secretary, and the power. These are the things I didn't show you guys because they're funny, because they make fun of, like, people. You guys will be able to see them later. You guys will each be, the person outside will get 3 of them. So, like, for instance, like, Arardi's Underwater Website Developers Club will take this one, and they'll go to the spot I tell them to. They can post one up because it's raining, and then I'd hold on to the other 2 to make sure they don't get wet, because if they all just like start like bleeding, then they're not going to be able to do the code. So wait, who's inside again? You're inside? All right, you can take this one.
Yeah, there's like barely enough miles. I'm not going to be here.
You're, so, oh, you're not?
All right, who wants, who else is inside? You? All right, here's one.
So which one do you want?
842.
Zombies.
Yeah,
if you're going to start with an easy to get writing utensil, make sure it's like really elaborate signing or something. Okay, so that's going to be
hard.
That's
good.
Okay.
Yeah,
website. Alright, so you guys know where you're going.
I'm going to the tunnel. Okay.
Alright. Do you have tape or do you need tape?
I need tape.
Alright.
I need tape.
Engineering will go.
I thought you were going to the sentinel.
For now?
Oh,
I think it's
yeah!
Like
a
Zombie team, here we go. Your feet noiselessly tread across the broken glass and rough gravel near the... I don't want to read all this, so you just have to. Important mission item.
That's not it.
No.
Fuck.
What's inside of the wall that contains...
Your feet noiselessly tread across... I've already read that. What's inside of the wall that contains you to the ruined city? You have no sense of the past and no designs of the future. All that exists for you is aching hunger and loneliness. The hive mind has not spoken to you, and without its anchoring presence, you feel lost. Suddenly, images force their way into your mind. You stumble against the wall as they crash into your unprepared psyche. The images show prey
flittering
in to building to building, darting out in search of something, and then diving in again once they have found it. You feel the overwhelming desire to rip them apart and feast upon the streaming innards. Easing the ache that lies at the very center of you. You recognize the building as those that lie near the center of the city. Shut up, guys. The images are digital, static, and cold. Everything the hive mind should not be. You can feel the barest trace of its straining presence to you in the background of... What? Background of the mental connection, sorry. It is as much as a captive as you are. A slave to the prey that managed to mangle its mind and bend it to their will. But as you turn inwards towards the city, the hive mind surges to the surface of your thoughts for the briefest of moments. You feel its contempt for its captors, and it's surely something so powerful that cannot be contained forever. TLDR, kill humans.
So it's like there's five objectives, but each objective has a sister objective, therefore making it like 10 objectives.
How many people do we
have? Or it's still five, and if you get 20, two is a five. Because
well, no, because the sister objective can only be found by decoding.
They're all one group right now.
That's what the decoder thing is for.
Yeah, I feel like two groups tonight would be a little bit better.
Since they're being split,
we need to split the central buildings.
All right.
What does that mean?
I gave a walkie to Johan and to Brad. Which one do you want to go with you? So that way we can communicate
Johan,
with you.
Johan, I like that name.
All right. Let's split up into two groups and move quick.
A professional zombie is pretty much a player that only ever plays zombie, and we try to organize the zombie horde a little bit more than usual. We try to lead the horde as best we can and just make sure that the zombies are on par with where they need to be and that they're playing fair. That's the important thing, and keeping the integrity of the game. That's what we as pro zombies do.
Human?
Apparently, let's go.
Kyle, it's an individual thing.
It's an individual thing?
Every human has to go to every spot. It's individual score. They don't have to go to
every one. Hey, Johan, key information. Key information about to come over. It is an individual human thing, not a team thing. So each human has to do it on their own.
It's not like a team thing. Every human has to do it.
Correct.
Understood.
All right, I'm moving out.
Kyle, we're going on a scouting mission. We'll be back momentarily.
First side we can trust.
Of course you can't hear me. He's talking.
Of course not. Yeah, I know that much. And if I see
them,
I'm going to
you having fun, Nimish?
Oh, my first mission of the night. Our previous HVZ advisor, he took us through the woods. And this was Monday night. We didn't see a zombie in the wood anyways, but he wanted to be safe. He took us through the swamp. I got messy. I got dirty, but it was a lot of fun. And then we ran past a group of zombies, but the zombies weren't looking at us. They were looking on the ground. Come to find out later, this kid had tripped over a tripwire, and I felt bad, but I didn't want to die as a human. So he went to the ER, but he was fine. And that was my first mission, and it was a lot of fun. I have running the game and playing the game. I probably have I can think of some good stories if I remember what the storyline was and what type of missions it was. It was there's definitely some stories from each one, and as you play, you will definitely understand that.
Humans is G. One, count them off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
The zombies have only gotten 9 people, so we're not really worried. Our biggest challenge has been not the zombies, but figuring out what we're actually supposed to be doing for the mission.
Yes.
Which is not exactly what we expected, but it's better than getting tagged by like 20 zombies.
More survivors.
What?
Hey, turn around. More survivors.
Love both teams' missions.
Because it was a little bit confusing about who can actually sign, especially since the moderators weren't actually telling us who's signed, like they can sign or when they sign or what they sign.
Well, I mean, you guys have the decoding sheet, right?
Yes.
Should probably use that.
Oh, yes. We're working on it. It's just like this whole, you can get signed, but like we didn't know if just one person needs to get signed at every location or everyone, or if just one person needs to solve the puzzle for the whole human side or everyone has to do it.
I can tell you that it is a per player mission.
Okay, per player.
For this flyer,
It's a pun on our club president, who can be a little power hungry at times. And the answer to the cipher is you are banned. And they have you are B-A-N-N. And they messed up the cipher at some point.
You are veneer.
Now they keep coming up with words like you are banner, you are bannix. And one of the kids behind them said, you are banned? And they all just told him he was an idiot and wrong. So hopefully they redo their whole cipher and get the letters back that they missed.
HVZ follows a storyline that they write up each year. Usually it follows the course of the students of in the city of RIT or whatever are being invaded by zombies because there's like a zombie apocalypse and we need to wait until the military can get here on Friday during the extraction mission to pick us up. So these missions tend to be like picking up supplies in different parts of campus or turning on like radio towers and lights and everything like that, and the zombies' goal is to stop the humans from doing that.
Every single game we have an escort, and that was fun. That's fun. Like this past game I ran with Team Clan Cancer, and that was as the human VIP for them, and that was a lot of fun because they were a bunch of my friends. They are outside of and they are inside of. Like they thought as an administrator I was trying to screw them, but it was definitely a lot of fun just running with them that night.
Yeah, it seems
I'm not sure.
I
didn't get to do anything.
Who was special last night?
Yeah.
If you were special last night, please take your hand out.
Okay. Who wants to be, all right, so instead of human, who wants to be zombie? Anyone, or do you just not care?
I don't care.
I played last night.
I want to be zombie.
If you need
so you'll be zombie no matter what. And then I have to figure out between you three and you, we need two more. And then no one else was anything last night.
I'll call seniority.
I was not a human. I have not been a VIP.
You watched.
I babysat Kyle.
I'll let you be one.
I
said I'll let you be one. Do you have some with you? Okay. And then with you three?
This is for being
you
human.
You were something, though.
You would be a
Yeah.
So, zombies, you're going to be leaving the trails. So, like, every once in a while, like, maybe every, like, 50 or 50, crack one, make sure it's glowing nice, and then put it in a nice spot that'll be, like, visible.
Okay.
Team 2.
Is that Phoenix or
Alchemist? Hey, guys.
Sorry that I like. Or do I take the guy
that
I want?
You get
your pick. Don't answer that.
Yeah, I know.
Okay.
Wait,
what?
Wait, what?
Wait, what?
Alright.
I have managed to cap a zombie VIP with a tracer round. He will be leaving iridescent blobs of goo on the ground. I suggest not touching it. Who knows what it's been infected with? Our objective tonight is to hunt down that zombie and eliminate it as fast as possible.
Yeah, come on.
Yes.
We gotta go to the other side. We gotta go to the second floor. Then
we need to be able to see Conan flying.
Oh, they're going over that way.
We're doing. We're in liberal arts.
Whoops.
Where was the target you guys saw?
Okay. Right there. I've already claimed it so that the other humans can't follow it.
Wait, so you actually picked up the... Oh, you're smart!
Yes!
Yeah. You're also hey, skill.
Which way was he moving? Which way
we
was
have
he
found
moving?
We have found the path going from 8 around Infinity Quad this way. There is
okay.
something.
So he's making this loop. His loop goes from the bus stop around and this way.
Yeah.
That means he's gonna come
that
back.
One is right there.
Yeah. Like, see that event? It was
the
like
thing is, five. Zombies are guarding him.
Here's the other thing that going from 8, like between 8 and 13, to here, we have not seen them go this way though.
They were going infinity that way.
Yeah.
All right, so they're trying to catch the second loop. There's three loops. There's one in dorms. There's one here in the middle of campus, and then there's one in Far Side Academic.
We have missions every night, starting at 9 p.m. going to 11, so they're 2 hours long, and they involve different sort of game types. We have like escort missions, like what happened at the Infinity Quad. We have collection missions, hold the point missions, and we try to do different variations on these. I mean, I'm using like generic types used throughout many different games. But we do switch it up, we do change them a little bit, we tweak them. We try to keep each of our missions new for this year. We don't want people to see repeats. Otherwise, people will master them and they'll get good at them, which we don't want. So the humans will go out, they'll get their mission. If they complete it, they get rewarded and survival becomes easier. If they don't, then survival becomes a lot harder. People die and it starts snowballing. And so it's up to the humans to be able to step up and complete this mission.
That group is circling the tunnels. We can get into the tunnels and pop out anywhere we want to try and ambush them. So, I mean, we can try and pop over to library, catch them while they're out there, knock them down, they move this way, we pop them here again, just try to whittle them down.
But the zombies are only going to be out for
five minutes.
If they walk slow enough, then we're not going to...
But the thing is, does the VIP have to keep moving?
Pretty much, yes.
VIP has to keep moving.
The ZVIP.
The ZVIP. Yeah.
Can the zombies, can stun Maybe. Zombies follow the VIP?
If you stun him, then he stops for 2.5.
Well, it's not and if you stun him.
If I stun him, they get a point.
So it's, technically, he's going to just keep moving.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Can stun zombies follow the VIP zombie?
They probably will.
They shouldn't, but so
regardless of if they can or not, they will.
Yes. And honestly, I wouldn't put it past many of them to just put their bandanas on once we disappear. Like, as they'll just be like, oh, I waited 5 minutes.
I called him, I didn't get a hold of him.
You didn't get a hold. Oh God!
So he's either busy
VIP yet?
Or
yeah, Gary.
No, you're VIP zombie.
Yeah, he's walking around with that giant ass fucking group that we're kind of trying to shadow.
Probably we need them.
Okay. Is there a zombie tier that gets
scout?
Rid of those?
Well,
yeah.
Yeah. Hold
there's a zombie tier that gets rid of those, isn't there?
Maybe. Yeah, I'll hold
the door. How
many shots can I get off?
I haven't calibrated it.
Can I use the gun to calibrate?
Tell him that we're holding the door until 4 minutes. Every time you smell weapons.
Okay, their loop is. I gotta catch my breath. Shut up. Don't answer me.
I'm not gonna think what a loop is.
Okay, loop is bus stop in front of 8.
Or 9.
This way.
Right? Kind of. Because they have to go through Infinity Quad.
Okay, it's like a figure 8 or something.
It looks like they might, but it looks like they go between 8 and 3.
But the horde, are they moving that way or that way?
They're moving this way. Oh. Garrett, hustle back in the door. It's like a puppy. You gotta tell him what to do.
Uh-huh. There's like a huge puppy.
Yeah. Alright, guys, down the stairs, we wait for him to pass.
Get down here, guys.
Down the stairs, stay somewhere where they can't see you. That includes you, camera guy.
In the NPCY. Okay, never
mind. They go between 12 and 8.
Door isn't locked, but okay.
You call him if
he's still watching the
easy call. Yeah.
What?
Yeah. Get shit done, son.
We got him stopped, though. We got the group to stop.
So, do we want to leave them here?
I'm going to follow them because they're following us. We're going to protect him.
Yeah, the thing is, but we can break some of them off.
That for 5 minutes, they're broken off.
Go down the tunnels. We're going this way.
Well,
oh. There we go.
See, there's a couple of them.
That's a lot of them, and a tank.
Oh, yeah, there's two tanks.
Okay, okay.
Get them.
Right,
tunnels, library.
Locked out.
Fuck.
Nope, no one in or out. It's locked out.
Fuck.
Other door.
Go.
Got it. I got your cover.
Go. There they are. Oh, he's right there. Okay.
Holy shit.
That door's open.
Fuck you, Arari. Fuck you, Arari.
I knew he was going to do it.
God fucking damn it.
I knew he was going to do it. Down in the library.
Right now.
I have a hostage.
I knew that was going to happen. I saw Tad take the pink thing out of his hand.
There's like one person in the
house. It's all right.
I saw Tad take the pink thing out of his hand. I tried to warn you guys, but no one was listening.
We just got locked out.
They used the lockout device, locked the door so we can't get through, killed the safe zone. We ran to the Delta One again. We're grouping up with other people.
They're going
and we cannot go through that door. If we are still in that safe zone after 5 minutes, we all become zombies.
Well, after a specified time.
Not 5 minutes.
Yeah.
It's not all you want.
A lockout is a new thing for this spring game, where an unmarked moderator or administrator walks up to the door, and it's planned out ahead of time, and then pulls their bandana out and says lockout. And at that moment, no one can go in or out of the door for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes,
the safe zone that would normally exist becomes electrified, and any player inside of it becomes a zombie. They get killed. 10 minutes later, the electric field goes away,
I'm just going to get one.
And at the 15-minute mark, the door is back to normal. And it's a way of keeping the players from camping the doors all night long.
Open both double doors now.
No, I got it.
What is it?
Guys,
watch those doors. I want a couple of fast fire weapons. Come on.
Roger that.
Is that another?
That's the group. The reason we're on the store.
We are not moving to you. The group is right there.
Single person comes up, tell us so we can turn around and see if we can confirm it's a mob or admin. If it is, we walk right inside this door. We don't want to get locked out again.
Okay. Especially not in this spot. The closest door is over
so
there.
One of you is just watching backwards for anyone to walk up.
Yeah. Is
I look left.
At that door?
I look right.
Yeah.
There's a whole bunch of humans
yes.
at that door.
Okay, the group is over there. They've moved into the library. I said you
here, I'll watch this door.
Outside. You learn a little bit more about yourself as a person. Because, you know, we always say whenever we see somebody, like in a movie or a TV show or a book or something, where they go and do something that seems evil at the time, where they leave somebody to die or something like that. I'm like, oh, we wouldn't do that. Well, you can't say that until you're put into that kind of position. And so we get to see some of that actual side of you come out in this game, you know. You see a guy running from two zombies. You're perfectly safe. Do you leave your safety to go help him, or do you just leave him to, you know, fate? And so that's probably something that you learn throughout this game.
Gasco's talking to someone over the radio.
Calling it.
Are you guys random people in your spawn plan?
Shots in heat, I need to work up our spawn.
First time being a tank, and that was fun. A tank is a special zombie that wears pink, and they can only get hit by socks to be neutralized, and they'll get neutralized for 2.5 minutes.
One of the things that we instituted was special zombies. Special zombies like tanks, boomers, witches, those guys, they were based off a game called Left 4 Dead, and that we instituted them as a unique twist. Versus just humans and zombies. These specials give zombies something to be and something for humans to fight.
Okay, listen. Half of your group go to the bus stop. We're gonna try and catch them right as they walk through that ramp. We have a group at 12. We have a small group plus the VIP at that door right there. If we have you guys here and then you guys there, we all converge on them and take them out. There's only two tanks, there's about 12 zombies. Each of us should be able to take at least three.
Everyone have a sock on them?
As soon as you hear me yell, you fucking go at them.
You guys have socks.
Because I'm going to yell to point them at us, and then you guys come behind them, got it?
Yeah.
Also, I hate to say it, but that's a little bit of an open position. But you can still probably make it to the SAU if you have to bug out. There's another group at SAU, 14-1, that you can meet up with and do theirs as well.
Okay?
They're coming. Get ready.
Okay. Group, go.
Actually, just stay there. Come this way.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah, Badger was on tank.
Okay.
Badger is with them. Badger is on tank.
Steampunk girl.
Clear.
She didn't go down a lot.
Clear away. Clear away.
Hey, so maybe we should start.
There, guys.
If you are fast, move forward. Wait. Something's happening.
That is a gas kill tag.
Did Garrett just
hit
me?
Yeah, that was a Garrett.
Garrett
is fucking awesome.
Garrett! Come here!
Mom!
He disappeared behind the
bus. Mom!
What's my back?
Come here!
Garrett, how many? I love you.
Did you get him?
Get him?
Twice.
Thank you,
Mario. Two shots?
Okay. Garrett, thank you, Mario. Awesome.
Let's
okay?
get back inside before one.
I owe you a lunch, okay?
I owe you, like, all.
You see me on campus. I owe you a meal, okay?
Maybe. We'll see.
Canada! Less zombies, the better.
But Canada's bad. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Whatever. All right, everyone, into the tunnels.
I totally just bum rushed him and just got him.
Garrett.
So I don't know who I'm going to assign that one to.
Garrett. Thank you. Okay.
Go deep into the tunnels, people.
Between 7 and 6, into Kodak, around 6.
There were a couple of people that said I couldn't hit stuff, and I've hit 3 for 3.
Like they could lead us away from the safe zones, and then we get
them. I'm not supposed to talk to you.
I know that.
I know.
Hello.
Dead men.
Bus stop again, maybe.
At least you distracted him long enough for him to be a badass.
Yeah, you got 2 shots.
Would you guys believe me if I said that was my plan?
Zombie,
exactly not my plan, because you guys didn't fucking move.
We didn't hear you.
I said
no. We did nothing.
We saw
the
you run out.
Exactly what you said.
We saw you run out. We weren't sure if you were trying.
In my defense,
I
moved.
You moved. Yeah, we
didn't. I don't care if you move.
Guys, he's distracted.
Yes.
Victory is determined if all the zombies kill all the humans, or if some humans gets the extraction point. The extraction point is the safe zone at the end of the game of day 5. And I've never actually gotten to that point, so I don't know much about it. Like, you just get the joy and the glory of getting to the extraction point.
Everybody, so Ted and I will be within visible range of each other, and we'll have a Sudoku puzzle for one side, and then 5 other different types of puzzles, like I Spy is one of them, Jenga. So, and then there's a couple more in there, like an actual jigsaw puzzle. And then we'll go, when say one side, I don't remember what it was to shut down the, we're both in safe zones. So then one of us solves the Sudoku puzzle. Whoever solves it first shuts down the other team's safe zone. And then while your team has a safe zone, you're completing one of these puzzles. And then the other team's trying to desperately solve a Sudoku puzzle probably in a safe zone. Just trying to desperately solve a Sudoku puzzle to kick down our shields. And then it's just gonna keep flip-flopping until one team's dead. And then we're gonna go to Gracie's and have fun.
When did he go swimming 2 yesterday?
He just downed a Nutri-Gain bar and a bottle of Gatorade.
And looked fine, probably. Like he was
doing
it.
He never knew. He just denied it for over a year.
Subtitle, Friday. 5 o'clock. We are in the Shumway Commons Dining Hall on the dorm side of campus, 4 minutes before the final mission starts. This is one of the VIPs for the human team. They will be meeting him here before 20 minutes after the mission starts, when they will leave to begin doing the puzzles that will create enough time for the humans being outside that one of the teams will be completely eliminated. The team that survives this onslaught will be escorted to an extraction point in the field behind the Gracie's Dining Hall, where they will be stranded. And then the mercenaries will hopefully come in to save them at the last second. Hopefully.
I think the wide player base that we have is very unique. Like, we have people that are super athletic, and then we have people that aren't. But everyone has fun, and we're definitely a community for that.
Two.
Him and who else?
Back up.
Guys, how about we all do the hokey pokey?
Point to
your favorite I Spy book.
If I was two, okay, two will go. No.
Let me have a playing I Spy, guys. Relax.
We're just playing I Spy.
I Spy with my little eyes some future zombies.
Alright.
We win, guys.
Oh, there we go.
You got it. You guys should go over there and
go childhood.
Wait for the flag! Come on, you do it.
Guys, kind of like make sure the wind doesn't.
Where's the wind coming from?
No, no, you're good. All right, so now, yeah. So you have one.
Take out the middle, so.
Take it slow.
This one.
One.
No, no.
I got it, Jungles.
Oh, man.
Come on!
All right, you guys are good.
Okay.
Please! Holy
shit, that was great. Hey,
three of you can now leave.
You know, they're in the future. He has to play multiple games of that.
Cassie, yo!
For this?
Thank you.
Zombies are the perfect example of working together. They always, like, they're always referred to as the Horde because that's what they do. They work together, they help people get tags. For instance, not this game, but before this game, zombies used to have starve timers, where if you didn't get a tag within a certain amount of time, you starved out, you had to stop playing. Well, what zombies did to counteract this, to make sure nobody starved, was that if you got a tag, you stopped starving. And then if they got any tags after that, they would share it with other zombies. And so they worked together really well. And of course, you have to use you have to work as a team in order to take down a group of humans. Because really, the zombies have very little in the way of advantages over the humans. All they have is numbers. Because I mean, if you're running at me, you have to tag me. I can shoot you with a Nerf blaster before you even touch me, before you get near me or hit you with a sock. And so the zombies have to use numbers in order to overcome the huge advantage that humans have. And so that's a perfect example of working together.
Damn it. You can't do it because you
What happened?
Briefing that said extraction 7 o'clock and gave us GPS coordinates. And then they only took 5 people and we're like, fuck it, we're dead.
Was it cancer?
Yes, it was cancer.
Fuck, we got Shane at least.
No, he had already got
it. Oh, he was safe?
Yeah, he had already got it.
Do you want your sock anywhere? Sock, spare
there's
sock,
one back.
Random sock?
Here, yeah.
Thanks, Shane.
There you go.
And after the humans solve all of their puzzles and one of the teams is eliminated, they'll be escorted to that extraction point marked out by the green flags way out in the field. Unfortunately, they will end up stranded out there and will need mercenary help to rescue them, which we will provide as we always do. One of the perks of being a moderator or an admin of this game is the fun of being a badass. Coming in to save people, not worrying about getting killed.
You know where to go? Maybe.
Maybe.
Not really.
This way? That
was useful.
Get out of here.
Oh, yeah, that's totally a great test.
Well, the humans are going to come from whatever direction that they are in right now, and we're going to extract them, and we're going to help them. I think they've earned the help, and the zombies will definitely be here. I'm sure word will spread among the Horde. There'll be cries. The zombies will all converge. Maybe the humans will make it, maybe not.
So what, looks at that. So what's going to happen? Essentially, we're all going to be hiding in the woods.
And
the humans are going to be led in the middle of this field, stranded. I think all hope is lost. We have to like pretty much cross the field through a whole horde of zombies. And now we're going to run out of the woods screaming with blasters firing at the zombies. And hopefully it'll have a nice element of surprise. And players will hopefully be like, holy crap, we have a chance to extract now. And That way, I mean, we can still die, so as I'm saying, I guess we'll die, but hopefully a few people will get out, if they're lucky. You know, it's extraction.
What,
I hope
it's
a
rock.
Anyone got a spare sock?
You can find a frog.
Automatic weapons.
All right, everyone.
I see the three of us just go sideways.
Yep.
It's like, yeah, fuck you guys.
You're not allowed to do some
sock.
What do you say?
I can't hear.
Can you repeat that one more time, Tat?
There's socks and Trumbull's back.
Okay, we're not, guys.
Final survivors.
Connor.
Guys, quiet!
Guys!
Is it that one?
Right, no!
Right.
So, one human made it, right?
No, he doesn't count.
Never mind. No humans made it. Except, five humans did find the secret extraction point that was with that was encoded in all the missions throughout the entire week. And then they made it out.
That's it.
Oh, yeah.
Are they here?
That's the only five.
Yeah. Connor made it out too.
Hey, more humans!
Oh god! Oh god!
This is a beautiful game. You know why?
I wasn't over here because I went over there.
Hey, zombies! What do we want?
Brains!
What do we want? Them?
Brains!
How do we want them?
Brains!
Who wants them?
Brains!
Oh, HBC is a very fun game. If you've never tried it before, I recommend you give it at least one try before you graduate. It's a great experience. You'll meet a lot of fun people, and I can almost guarantee you'll have a positive experience.
Just try it, see if you like it, because it's a great experience. You get to learn about yourself. You get to work with other people, and it's a great way to meet new people. Like, I've met so many friends through this game because we have 800 people play in the fall. And so it's a great way to meet new people, and it's really the best club on campus, and I think our numbers prove that.
Woo!
I go back to your studies.
This is what I got for being a mod.
No,
yeah. No, I've not gotten hit yet.
The boy B Kyle.
There's a mod over there who has not been
hit. Again? Again?
That happens every year. I mean, all the mods get, because it's kind of like playful fun for the mods. I mean, the mods are there to, like, you know, keep the rules and gear. They kind of to be strict, hard asses with the rules. But, I mean, it's all good fun when we just pie them. And it's tasty.
Come here. Finn.
And
Finn,
so
come here.
Ends our careers Finn. Running humans versus zombies at RIT. Oh.
We'll meet again next fall.
Trumbull still has none.
It's not that bad. Adamants taste delicious.
Yeah, it does.
They do. Tastes like whipped cream.
Tastes like victory.
Did Tat get away too?
Knew you were going to say that.
I know.
Wave it proud, man. Just, where's my orange bag?
Here, Chris.
What would I like to say? That's a tough one because I don't really want to leave. Like, the HBZ community, I realize running the game, playing in the game, has been my last 3 years of my RIT experience. 3 out of 4 I transferred in, but it was definitely, no, actually I was playing since my first year here, so it was 4 years out of my entire RIT career here, HBZ has been the greatest. So having parting words is tough because I don't feel like I'm ready to let go. And
At the same time, I feel like the administration that we have coming in is going to be great. So, parting words would be, it's a game, have fun with it. Yeah, that's about all I got. I don't have much to say because I feel like I'm gonna be getting messages halfway through the summer saying, what should we do here? And I'm okay with that. So I'm not completely severing my ties with HVZ here.
Hey, Tom, it's Bob from the office down the hall. Good to see you, buddy. How have you been? Things have been okay for me, except that I'm a zombie now. I really wish you'd let us in. I think I speak for all of us when I say I understand why you folks might hesitate to submit to our demand. Here's an FYI, you're all gonna die screaming.
All we wanna do is eat your brains.
We're not unreasonable, I mean no one's gonna eat your eyes.
All we wanna do is eat your brains.
We're at an impasse here, maybe we should compromise. Open up the door, we'll all come inside and eat your brain. I don't want to nitpick, Tom, but is this really your plan? Spend your whole life locked inside a mall. Maybe that's okay for now, but someday you'll be out of food and guns, and you'll have to make the call. I'm not surprised to see you haven't thought it through enough. You never had the head for all that bigger picture stuff. But Tom, that's what I do, and I plan on eating you slowly.
All we wanna do is eat your brains.
We're not unreasonable, I mean no one's gonna your eyes.
All we wanna do is eat your brains.
We're at an impasse here, maybe we should compromise. If you open up the door, we'll all come inside and eat your brains. I'd like to help you, Tom, in any way I can. I sure Tom, well, technically I am, I guess I ground somehow. Meanwhile, I'll report back to my colleagues who were chewing on the doors. I guess we'll table this for now. I'm glad to see you take constructive criticism well. Thank you for your time. I know we're all busy as hell, and we'll put this thing to bed when I bash your head open.
All we wanna do is eat your brains.
We're not unreasonable, I mean no one's gonna eat your eyes.
All we wanna do is eat your brains.
We're at an impasse here, maybe we should compromise. You open up the door,
Wait, I was trying to
talk
to the tank.
Where's the filmmaker?
And there were other zombies around.
NAMS! I'm right here. Ready?
Let Kyle and Legion get him. Let Kyle and Legion get him.
Oh.
Get him already.
All right, Lee. Final words from the master of HVZ.
I had fun. And I hope you guys did too.
Yes!